So let us learn about the time delay. What is this time delay? By now we know how can you display your current date and time. But if you want to display your date and time after few seconds or after few minutes, how would you do that? So there are certain methods available where you can make your program sleep for some time and then display the date and time. So in this example, we will be seeing how you can display the current date and time and then make your program sleep for 3 seconds and then display the current date and time. That is, what is the date and time now and what would be the date and time after the 3 seconds. So let us understand with the help of this program, where we have used the package, we imported the package called java.util.asterisk because the date class is available in this package. Then we have created a class called sleep demo. In this class we write a main method. Now in the main method we will write the try catch block, where in the try block first we are trying to display the current date. If you remember, by now we were writing the date class, then creating a new object and then printing it. The other way would be to directly provide the constructor with the help of a new keyword. That is, you creating a new object of a date class. So you display new date in the bracket. Now this will print your current date and time, that with the help of println method. One important thing that we need to now notice is that we have provided or called a sleep method, which says that please make your program sleep for number of seconds or milliseconds or minute. That depends on you how much you provide, right? So here 1000 milliseconds is equal to 1 second, and our program says that we want our program to sleep for 3 seconds and then display the date and time. So how do you make your program sleep? With you call a sleep method over your thread class. So you write thread.sleep and then in bracket you provide your seconds. You could have directly provided as 3000, which would consider milliseconds, because this sleep method takes the parameters of milliseconds. You need to provide the value in milliseconds. It will not take in minutes or seconds, right? So this 5 into 60 is your 300, into 10 is your 3000. Either you can provide 3000 or any value which comes up to 3000. And if you want to make any changes apart from 3 seconds, if you want to make it for a minute or for 4 seconds, 5 seconds, you can change the value here. So now you have printed your date and time and then you made your program sleep for 3 seconds. So what is our purpose? To again print the date and time after these 3 seconds. So again you create a new object of the date class and print the date. So this block of statements will allow to print the date and time first and then sleep the program for 3 seconds and then again provide the current date and time. And then once this block of statements is executed, what kind of an exception may occur, you will store it in your exception. So this is how you make your program sleep for certain period of time with the help of thread.sleep method, and this sleep method will take the parameters in milliseconds and not in minutes and all. So let us execute this program practically to understand how you can make your program sleep for certain seconds and what would be the output after those seconds. This example program will explain us how can we make our thread or the computer to sleep for a second. So we have created a class called as time delay, and under the main method we should write the block of statements which needs to be executed. When we run a program, it may also throw an exception or an error. So we have a block called try and catch, which will help us in understanding how can you catch an exception when it is thrown. So under try block, we write the block of statement which needs to be executed, and if this block of statement throw any exception or error, that needs to be catched by a catch block. So by default we write an exception and we create an object of it, and then we print the exception if we receive an exception. Or you can also write at what kind of an exception it is. So you need to write system.out.println and provide the object, and this object is nothing but which holds the value or what kind of an error it is, it will print that. So let us see
How can you delay a thread or a task of a computer to print the value? Till now we have seen how can you display a date. So similarly we'll write system.out.println where we used to create an object of new, that is of date class. So new date, it will print a new date, and this is nothing but for next line. In the next line we say that please make the thread or the task of the computer to sleep for a second, where this is presented in milliseconds. So this program helps us in understanding how can a current thread or task can sleep for a specified number of milliseconds, where 1 second is equal to 1000 milliseconds. And this we can write with the help of a thread class. So we write thread dot sleep, which is a method, and how many seconds, that is milliseconds, you would want your thread to sleep. So we have written 1000 and then semicolon. Let us now print the date. What would be the date after we made our system sleep for 1000 milliseconds? System.out.println new date. Let us save the file and run. If you see, we haven't received any exception, otherwise it would have shown here. Let us again run this file. First, it will print the date, that is at 24, and then after 1 second, the system will display the date, because there's a gap of 1000 milliseconds where we are making our system sleep for 1000 milliseconds. If you want, you can increase the time as well. Now it is 44. Let us see when does it display. So the computer had slept for a period of time, and then it will display the value, which is at 54, right? So which is 10 seconds. You can also write the value as you're comfortable with. We can write 10,000 is nothing but 100 into 100. Let us see if we get the same output. So we have got the time as 11 seconds. The next one should be displayed at 21, which is 10 seconds after 11. As you can see the output. Now, if you want to use a for loop to iterate the value or to print the value after every 1 second or after any 10,000 milliseconds, whatever you would want to provide the value, you can do that. So what we do here is that we create a for loop. If you remember, first we need to initialize the variable. I make it as int I because it is an integer type. I initialize the variable with 1. Then you need to provide the condition. I say I should be less than equal to 10 and increment the I value with 1. So we close this loop after our thread, because once this condition is satisfied, please print the new date. Let us now save this program and run. So if you see 17, 18, 19, 20. So after every second, the system is printing the value, but it sleeps for 1000 milliseconds and then it prints the value.